zombie must take cover.
I will never forgive you for betraying this family. None of us will.
Thank you.
Merce, if I knew Silas was involved, I would have never...
Shut your mouth. I am sick to death of your lies.
I'm not lying. Not anymore. Seth hates his granddad, honestly.
You threw us right under the bus. You stupid, spoiled brat.
Too right. You know what? I have never felt this betrayed in my life. Well, apart from when I found out that my mum was a serial killer off.
I didn't mean to hurt anyone. I fell in love and I couldn't help but dream of the happily ever after. Me, Seth, a home. But we were broke, so...
So you decided to rinse your own family.
It wasn't like that.
It's exactly like that. Cleo is on her way.
Hey, did you text Joel?
Why would I?
Because he's part of this family as well. He needs to know what's going on. And Bobette is going to be here soon, so we all need to be here. Hey, have you robbed my phone?
No, why would I?
Because I won't put anything past you, you lying little troll.
I was so stressed. I had a miscarriage.
Exactly. We've been through months of torture because of you.
I'll make it up to you all for the rest of my life. I will.
OK. Well, you can start by leading us to Silas. Well,
I've told you, I don't know where he is.
Well, we've already established that you're a liar, so maybe have a long, hard think and start talking now.
Oh, so sorry, it's just really tense in here.
Do you know the thing that gets me the most? It's the fact that you thought Seth actually wanted you.
He does. He loves me. Well, that's why we...
You still believe it, you sad, pathetic little girl. The guy was just using you.
I know I've been awful, but you're just going to keep attacking me.
You ain't seen nothing yet. Not after what you did to my daughter. Cher has been hiding that secret for years, grieving her sister and blaming herself. It's been awful for her.
Do you know what? She made a life here, a good one, and you have just threw a grenade at it. So don't play Miss Innocent with us, Teresa. We all know that you're evil.
I'm not a horrible person. I was just lonely. But you all won't get that because... Well, you're never short of male attention. Of proper, honest, romantic love. Look at you two. And look at you. Goldie, engaged to Joel. You've all found your happily ever afters. And I just wanted a piece of that.
You were jealous.
Who wouldn't be? I looked at you two and I could tell that you'd survive anything the blackmailer threw at you. But me, I just go from one terrible relationship to the next. Tony, he was in love with Jackie. Calvin and Carmel, they were soulmates. Patrick, he only kept me around because he wanted me to be his carer. Really, he wanted Maxine. Dodger picked Maxine over me and then Newt dumped me for Anita, so...
I'm struggling to see where this is going.
Well, don't you see the pattern? Seth, he's the only one that actually wants me. So I had to grab it with both hands. And it fed all your darkest secrets to a psychopath. I see that now. But please believe me when I say... I love this family.
No! You're no McQueen. The runt of the litter you are. We should have given you away the day you were born.
I'm just saying Teresa could still come with us. We could be a proper happy family.
Oh, pass me the sick bag. Teresa's a harlot, just like all the other McQueen women. The sooner you realise that, the better.
If Teresa came with us, she could be a massive help. With Bobby, I mean. She's been helpful so far, hasn't she?
Bobby's an impressionable young boy. I'll not have her influence clouding his judgment. Do you really think you could trust her? No. Anyone who knows too much is an obstacle. A hindrance, not a help. And any obstacles need to be got rid of.
Listen, when you promised you weren't going to hurt anyone, you meant it, right? This is just about getting to see Bobby.
Of course. And now that we've clarified that, you go and collect the passports while I get Bobby from the airport and meet me back here, sharpish.
Whatever you need.
Marvelous to see a change in attitude in you, Seth. Because I've got one last game left to play.
Here.
Finally she arrives. Even Joel got here before you.
Joel?
Yeah, he's already inside bickering with his wife-to-be.
What was it you wanted anyway? Your message sounded urgent.
Silver's gone to get Bobby from airport and I just needed extra hands here.
Oh, yeah, of course. You know I'm always here to help you.
Right, well, you can go check on the spread and I'd avoid them too because they are on one.
Are you sure you don't want to just talk about things?
No.
You know, like Teresa and that?
No, thanks.
Where is she anyway?
Nana's grilling her upstairs. She's insisting that she's told us everything.
Maybe she has.
And if she hasn't, Nana will get it out of her, so come on. Crack on.
Babe, my battery died. Is Bobby here?
You were supposed to be picking him up from the airport, remember?
Yeah, that's where I've just come from. They told me a family member's already picked him up.
Well, none of us lot have. So where is my little boy?
So, my mum knows I'm here with you, right?
How many more times? Me picking you up so we could spend some time together was her idea.
Okay.
Don't you want to get to know your great-granddad?
Yeah, it's just...
Do you know, your father was my favourite grandson.
He was?
He was. And your grandmother, Heidi, she would have been so happy to meet you too. If only she were alive to see this moment.
What's this?
Have a look.
Did you make a treasure hunt for me?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, these clue cards are class.
I can see you share my love of mysteries.
So, what happens if I win?
A win or lose, your life is going to be much, much better from now on. Off you go.
Where is my son?
I have no idea. Oh,
don't you lie to me again.
I'm not lying. I don't know what you're talking about.
Bobby's missing, and there's a big blonde cuckoo in the McQueen's nest.
I swear on my daughter's lives, I know nothing about Bobby going missing.
Babe, if for once she's telling the truth, then we're wasting valuable time.
She insisted on Bobby coming back from Spain. She even paid for the ticket.
I organised Bobby's trip back because Seth said he wanted to meet his nephew.
Oh, right. If that is the truth, then why are you only just telling me this now? No, this is part of Seth's plan.
No, he wouldn't.
He would, Teresa. For Silas, he would.
Well, Teresa was blackmailing for Seth. Seth was doing it for Silas, and now Silas has got Bobby.
That pretty much sums it up.
Oh, my head is spinning. I mean, Silas could be halfway around the world now, and if he's kidnapped Bobby, who knows which one of us could be next?
I don't think you've got anything to worry about, Goldie.
You don't know that.
It's all right, babe. I'll keep you safe.
No.
How's Bobby?
I've sent him off on a little treasure hunt.
What? No, we don't have time for games. If we don't leave now, they might catch up with us.
I've waited a long time
for my revenge, Seth. I'm not going to rush it.
But we've got Bobby. What more could you want?
Excuse me. I've got Mummy Dearest on the line.
Now, what do you think I need to say to her?
To get her to walk straight into my trap.
Bobby's still not answering his phone.
Do you not think you should be calling the police? We're not the biggest fan. Come on.
He's right, Mercedes. It's something we need to consider.
No, Nana, we're not calling the police. Because if this is Silas, then that will make it 10 times worse. And then Silas will go on the run and we'll never see Bobby again.
Goldie!
What? I'm just being honest, Nana.
I'm going to try Bobby's phone again.
Hello, Mercedes.
This is your old friend. And we've got one final game to play.
Go to the folly.
And don't tell a soul.
It's time to compete for the ultimate prize.
And I'd advise you not to break the rules,
or you'll never see your little boy again.
Still nothing?
No. I'm gonna get some fresh air.
Hello, old friend.